Good morning, everybody. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. We are in the Ayurveda College, Nigdi, Pradhikaran, Pune 44. Today is a Monday, that is 30th of December 2019. The time is 10 to 11 a.m., morning 10 to 11. Actually, this is a accidental visit of Professor Deshpande in the class because it is not expected that on the 30th, that is on Monday, Dr. Deshpande should take this class. But as my colleague, Dr. Professor Chobe Madam has, as an emergency, made a message that she couldn't come or she cannot come today because of the medical problem or medical leave. And my another colleagues, for example, Dr. Vijaya Madam, she is also on the half day. My another colleague, third colleague, that is Dr. Shweta More, is busy in the CAP. That means Central Assessment Program. CAP is the word, Central Assessment Program. In simple Marathi language, paper tapasnyache kam. Atta aplya mahavidyalayamadhye varcha majlyavarti custody madhye paper tapasnyache kam chalu aahe, and she is in charge of that particular program, which is called as a CAP, CAP director. So Dr. Shweta More is working as a CAP director. That's why Dr. Deshpande has all of a sudden got a chance to come to the class and take some or busy the students in some, what you can say, the ideal and fruitful activity. So Dr. Deshpande has planned, as this is accidental and all of a sudden responsibility on Dr. Deshpande's head, so he is not expected to bother to the students as well as to get bothered for himself. So what is the mean, what is the simple thing that he can do is the shloka patantar or chanting of important shlokas. So today's next 30, 40, 45 minutes will be chanting of Ayurvedic Sharira Kriya Shloka, and we will start from the handbook, and I have made my students to make a compulsory notebook for theory as well as the practical, and the students are asked, although they are not today prepared for the study material of Professor Deshpande, they are expected to go at home, write in their theory book that Dr. Deshpande has taken this Dr. Chobe Madam's period as an emergency, and at that period he has taken the shloka recitation or shloka patantar in Marathi. I have also made a students to buy a compulsory simple but short and sweet book that is called as a Handbook of Sharira Kriya Vijnan, published by Shantanu Prakashan. The authors are Deshpande, Chobe and Vavar, and although there may be a shortage or there may be the copy is not available, hard copy out of print is there. So any students can get the Xerox copy from Dr. Deshpande or from their friends and make that copy with them all the time. Because myself, Deshpande is very confident that if the students learn by heart whole book, 150 pages, then they will definitely get minimum first class in the theory as well as practical. Because that handbook covers the paper 1, some important points of the syllables, paper 2, important points of the syllables, as well as some practicals, RBC, WBC, instruments. And not only that, but he has mentioned also the histology. Histology was the topic 2014, up to the 2014, that was the topic of the syllabus of Sharira Kriya Vijnan. Histology was in the Sharira Kriya Vijnan, that is physiology. But after 2014, CCM had changed that histology will be in the anatomy and not in the physiology. Is it clear? And that's why in this book you will find the histology also diagrams and how to identify that histology slides. Whether you have any lecture on the histology in anatomy? Anybody? Up till now? Or at least the teachers has mentioned that they have the topic of histology in your anatomy? Has anybody informed? Or have you seen personally? I think there is histology in anatomy, am I right? And I don't know whether that particular department has an independent slides under the microscope, or they can borrow those slides which are also in the Sharira Kriya department, because that topic was previously in the Sharira Kriya department. Now those who have the handbook, they can keep the handbook in front, and those who do not, they can just listen to me and repeat my all the wordings just by listening to those words. We will start with the chanting of shloka from page number 76. Dhatu Sarata. Dhatu Sarata is a very important concept of Sharira Kriya Vijnan. Dhatu means body tissues, सेवन धातूज रस रक्त मांस मेद अस्थि मज्जा एंड शुक्र एंड सारता दैट इज द क्वालिटी टेस्टिंग वेदर माय रस धातु इज द बेस्ट क्वालिटी मॉडरेट क्वालिटी और द बैड क्वालिटी द आयुर्वेदिक वर्ड्स आर उत्तम सारता मध्यम सारता एंड हीन सारता I have already told you that my many topics are repeated 100 times. Now this is the chance that you can have the revision of Dhatu Sarata. So Sarata means quality testing. Just for understanding purpose, if I want to see whether my patient has a good quality of Rakta Dhatu, so at the moment we have the biochemistry available. For example, you can do the hemoglobin estimation. In the laboratory, you can do the hemogram. Hemogram is the name of the test. And what it includes? Hemogram includes hemoglobin, RBC count, WBC count, and platelet count. So all these factors are included in the word hemogram. It approximately cost in the laboratory from 100 rupees to 200 rupees. This is very, very fundamental test. If any chronic patient comes to you, any chronic, I am having the pain in the abdomen, I am having the fever, I am having the cough, I am having the diarrhea, I am having the dysentery, I am having the diabetes, whatsoever, if the patient comes to you with the complaints more than 15 days, every doctor must perform some basic investigations. That is a duty of a doctor. He should not do only clinical examination and start Ayurvedic, homeopathic, no. As the complaint, as the disease is more than 15 days, he should test his basic physiological status, basic things. So this is a new knowledge for you. Anybody wants to write, they can. I am not going to dictate anything. Whatsoever you want, you can write fastly in your notebook. This is a very applied part I am telling you regarding your dispensary, regarding your practice. Although I have declared that I am going to take the shlokas, but the point is coming through the shloka. Because Rakta Dhatu Sarata, I am asking you to do the hemoglobin, and hemoglobin is a part of hemogram. And then I have gone further. Why hemogram is included? There are some basic tests which every doctor should perform, whether he is practicing Ayurveda, allopathy, homeopathy, naturopathy. He must perform this test. Otherwise, if you send to the consultant, MD, MS, they basically do this test and then start any treatment. So, which are these basic tests? Number one, hemogram. As I have told you, it costs round about 100 to 200 rupees in Indian currency. While sending your patient to the laboratory, take important precaution. That pathological laboratory should have the in-charge doctor, MD pathology. He should not be only DMLT, that is a course of lab technician. He should not be only MBBS. He should not be only BAMS. No, I am talking about pathological lab. Who should be the head of the pathological lab? Some MD pathologist should be there, who is signing, who is reporting. Then and then those tests can be said authentic. Otherwise, there can be a gafla in Marathi or Hindi. So you should be very careful while performing the test, especially who is already suffering from 15 days. Don't send any casual laboratory. No. See whether that laboratory is authentic. There is an MD doctor. You have talked with that doctor by the phone and then you send the patient. So hemogram, many times one more investigation is added and it's like a pair, hemogram ESR. But there is a difference. Some doctors say only hemogram. Many doctors say hemogram plus ESR. ESR erythrocyte sedimentation rate. If this test added hemogram plus ESR, charges increases. In spite of 200, it will be 250 or 300. Are you getting my point? There is a difference. So you must see whether I need the ESR or not. But in many chronic cases, better to do the ESR, erythrocyte sedimentation test. Next important part, ESR is not diagnostic test. ESR is not diagnostic test. This is prognostic test. Write down that word, prognostic, not diagnostic. तुम्ही त्याच्यावरून आजाराचे निदान करू शकत नाही. तुम्ही तो आजार बरा होतोय का नाही हे ठरवू शकता. मराठीमध्ये तुम्ही आजाराचं डायग्नोसिस नाही करू शकत, तुम्ही आजार बरा होतो का नाही हे तपासू शकता. प्रोग्नोसिस मीन्स वेदर इट इज गोइंग टू क्युअर ऑर इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू क्युअर. इट इज इन द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ क्युअर ऑर इट इज नॉट इन द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ क्युअर. Especially ESR is very, very important in two or three diseases. Number one, tuberculosis. Tuberculosis, TB, chest, skin, bone, intestine. TB can occur at any part of your body. This is another understanding. Because you know only TB means smoking, chest, cavity, okay, X-ray chest, finish. But no. Tuberculosis can take place in any part of the body. TB of the bone, here vertebra is very common. TB of the vertebra, remember. TB of the knee joint, very common. TB knee joint, very common. TB of the intestine, common. TB of the skin, common. Try to understand, this is a new knowledge for you. Nobody has told you up till now. And this is every word of today's lecture is a most practical word. Those who are very curious to get the knowledge, confirm knowledge, because this is all knowledge will be useful in the second year, in the third year, in the fourth year, and you will be more confident. Yes, we know. Yes, we know. So hemogram, ESR, ESR is not diagnostic, this is prognostic test. Hemogram, you get the knowledge of the hemoglobin. Normally it should be 12 to 14 gram percent per 100 ml. But if it is less than 10, what will happen? Its, what you can say, the vital energy of the life will be less. Vital energy, strength will be less. So whatsoever, he may be having fever, he may be having cough, he may be having diabetes, he may be having cancer. Any disease will not be easily cured. Why? No oxygen. Hemoglobin is carrying oxygen. So oxygen carrying capacity is less. So whatsoever you are giving treatment for arthritis, tuberculosis, diabetes, cough, cold, diarrhea, you should take care of the hemoglobin. Is it clear? And hemoglobin is carried in the bag of RBC, red blood cell. This is a bag like structure and they carry the hemoglobin in it. So RBC count will automatically may be less. When hemoglobin is less, moreover times RBCs are also less. WBC are soldiers. You have studied in the school level. White blood cells, pandrya peshiya aple sainik ahet. So white blood cells are like the soldiers. They are ready to fight with the infections. Normal count is 4 to 11,000 per cubic mm. WBC count 4 to 11,000 per cubic mm. This will be in the practical with Dr. Shweta More, madam. So when this count is up to the 15,000, more than 11, 15,000 per cubic mm, it's called as a mild bacterial infection. Mild bacterial infection. It may be tonsillitis, pharyngitis, bronchitis, enteritis, sinusitis, anything. only by looking to the WBC count, you will understand that the patient must have some infection. Is it clear? When that is 15,000 to 20,000, it's a moderate infection. And when the count is more than 20,000 per cubic mm, it is a severe infection. And mostly this infection, hidden infection, is related with the urine, remember. Urinary tract infection. That will give the count like 20,000 per cubic mm. So you must find out where is the infection, where is the infection. If it is cough, it is very clear. When the patient is coughing, infection must be in the cough. If he is having the diarrhea, natural infection in the intestine with the diarrhea. But many times, especially about urine, the patient don't want to talk directly with the doctor. About the urinary complaints, patient don't want to talk about urine. Do you understand? He can talk diarrhea, he can talk cough, he can talk fever, he can talk joint pain, but he don't talk about the urine. So whenever you will find WBC count has increased, no cough, no diarrhea, no joint pain, where is the problem? You can directly ask the patient, tumhala lagvila jaljal hote ka? Lagvi kartana dukhta ka? Lagvi kutlya rangachi hote? All these questions are in Marathi. You must ask about the urinary complaints. Whether the patient is suffering from dysuria, dys means painful, dysuria, or burning, micturition, or dark yellow color urine, or cloudy urine, cloudy, C-L-O-U-D-Y, cloudy urine. Normally our urine is clear, but this is a cloudy. Marathi madhe apan ghat, gadad, gadul, gadul laghi lao te. Batli gelanda asa ghatte ghatte kaitri disto. Patal panasarka disat nahi. So that is called as a cloudy urine. All these will be again repeated by Dr. Chobhe madam when she will tell you about the urine examination. Now we are talking about WBC count. If WBC count is higher, where is the hidden infection? It may be related with the urinary tract, and that is called as a UTI. Very simple word, UTI. Urinary tract infection. Don't get confused with the word URTI. This is another word, URTI. Upper respiratory tract infection. These words are different. URTI is related with the cough. URTI, upper respiratory tract infection. UTI, urinary tract infection. So whenever hemogram WBC will show, of course this is a basic investigation, hemogram, then ESR, then third is a urine routine examination. Always you do, whenever the patient is above 15 days complaints of any disease or any simple minor symptoms, but anything above 15 days, more than 15 days, fever, cough, diarrhea, arthritis, diabetes, anything, basic investigations, hemogram, ESR, then urine routine, it is called as a urine routine. In the hemogram, I forgot to tell you, there is one important remark you should mention to the pathologist. It is called as a, please do the PBS. What you should write to the pathologist? Please do PBS, peripheral blood smear. Peripheral blood smear, PBS. And next you write for what? MP, capital MP, malarial parasite. So whenever the hemogram is done, some on the glass slide blood is taken, a simple strip is prepared, smear is prepared, and that smear with staining is seen under the microscope. that is called as a PBS, and why we have to look for the malarial parasites. A cyst or the eggs are seen in the your slide in the blood. Malaria is a common infection which is not getting cured with repeated antibiotics also. Specific anti-malaria treatment should be given. So we are talking about basic investigations. I mentioned you about hemogram, ESR, and then urine routine. Third basic investigation, third, fasting and post glucose blood sugar. Fasting and post glucose blood sugar. Very important, because nowadays many times diabetes is detected accidentally. Patient do not have any complaints. Patient do not have any complaints. So, fasting and post glucose. Now, here is also very interesting part. You can learn about this here only. When the patient is a not known diabetic, remember my words, not known diabetic. That means previously he was not detected as a diabetic patient. First time he is not knowing whether I am a diabetes or not. ते मागचे डॉक्टर म्हणाले तुम्हाला असू शकतो पण नाही आमच्या काही गोळे चालू नाही औषध चालू नाही डाएट कंट्रोल काही चालू नाही आहे मला माहित नाही काय मला डायबिटीस आहे का नाही. इफ द पेशंट इज अनअवेअर दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अ नॉट नोन डायबेटिक देन यू शुड डू द फास्टिंग अँड पोस्ट ग्लुकोज. फास्टिंग मीन्स विदाउट टेकिंग एनी फूड इन द मॉर्निंग. ॲट 8 o'clock ही हॅज टू गो टू द लॅबोरेटरी. युजली पॅथॉलॉजिकल लॅबोरेटरी इज ओपन अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग. रिमेंबर माय वर्ड्स. ॲट 8 o'clock. Usually offices open at 10 o'clock, 9 o'clock, but labs open at 8 o'clock because for this investigation, all fasting tests are done early in the morning. Because patient cannot stay without tea, without breakfast, without biscuits up to 11 o'clock, no. So when his blood is taken, then fasting sample is over. Then he can eat something and then again go for another test. But some tests are done in the fasting or the empty stomach. Patient is allowed to take the water. Remember, patient is allowed to take the water. There is no problem of drinking the water. Otherwise, the patient may become fainting attack. So, patient can drink from the night till going to the lab. He can't do anything. But no food, no breakfast, no tea, T-E-A, no tea. That is called as a fasting sample. Is it clear? So, fasting and post glucose blood sugar. What is post glucose? After giving the fasting sample in the pathology lab, many pathological labs, they prepare ready-made sarbat of glucose powder. In the market you can see there is a Glucon D packet is available. 75 gram of powder is mixed in the water. 75 gram of glucose powder, Glucon D powder, is mixed in the water, and some lemon or some, what you can say, fragmented or scented, some juice drops are to take that particular water, glucose water, because it's very difficult to take, drink such a saturated solution of the water. But the patient is asked to drink that glucose sarbat or glucose water. After drinking that water, again the blood is taken exactly after 1.45 minutes. 1 hour and 45 minutes. Or at the dot after 2 hours. But usually at sharp 2 o'clock is very difficult. So usually blood is taken from 1.45, that is 1 hour and 45 minutes, up to the 2 hours. So that sample is called as a post glucose blood sugar. If anybody has any doubt, they can definitely raise their hand and ask, because it's very interesting part, very useful for your practice. Although I am recording, you are allowed to ask me anything. You can stop me and ask me, there is no problem. Don't get botheration, oh my God, sir is talking and recording. No. Anybody has difficulty, because this is very critical. To diagnose the diabetes, which important test we do? Fasting and post glucose. Now, if the patient is non-diabetic, patient is non-diabetic, that means he is taking some insulin, he is taking some medicines, he is doing some exercises, he is taking specific diabetic diet. And patient is say, yes, since last 2 years, last year I have detected, I have the diabetes. But doctor say, no tablet is required, you only control your diet and do the exercise. But patient is non-diabetic. Is it clear? Then these tests are modified. Then the fasting and PP is done. Write down. Fasting, that is common. And PP, capital, postprandial. P-R-A-N-D-I-L. PP, postprandial. P-R-A-N-D-I-L. In Marathi language, जेवणानंतर 2 तासाने पुन्हा रक्त घ्यायचे. एकदा काही न खाता पिता घ्यायचे. सकाळी 8 वाजता पेशंटला सांगायचे, घरी जावा, तुम्ही तुमचा ब्रेकफास्ट करा नेहमी करता तसा, तुम्ही तुमचं 12 वाजता जे जेवता तसं जेवा, 1 वाजता जेवत असाल तर 1 वाजता जेवा, नेहमीच्या वेळेला जेवा. आणि जेवल्यानंतर बरोबर 1.5-2 तासाने आमच्या लॅबमध्ये या, आम्ही तुमचे ब्लड घेऊ. सो आय हॅव एक्सप्लेन्ड इन मराठी ऑल्सो हाऊ यू शूड टॉक विथ द पेशंट. Patient is asked after fasting sample, go home, do your routine. If you are taking breakfast, take the breakfast. If you are doing the lunch at 12 o'clock, take the lunch at 12 o'clock. If you are taking the lunch at 1 o'clock, take the lunch at 1 o'clock. For example, the patient has completed his food, completed his lunch at 12 o'clock. He should look in the watch, clock. Now it is 12, okay. When he should take the another sample, postprandial, at 2 p.m. But in spite of going to the 2 p.m., he should visit to the lab 15 minutes before. So exactly 1 hour and 45 minutes, the technician will take the sample. And that sample is called as a postprandial blood sugar. Is it clear? So for not known diabetic, always fasting and post glucose. And in non-diabetic, fasting and PP blood sugar. We are talking about basic investigations that doctor should prescribe, doctor should write. Any patient having any disease, any symptoms, any complaints, more than 15 days duration. Am I right? The topic is clear. We have talked about hemogram, ESR, urine routine, fasting and post glucose. Next test, serum urea, U-R-E-A, serum, S-E-R-U-M, urea, U-R-E-A. And another test, serum creatinine, C-R-E-A, C-R-E-A-T-I-N-I-N-E, creatinine. So urea and creatinine, try to understand, these are the waste product after protein metabolism. Usually they are excreted from the kidney. Urea and creatinine are waste products. Okay? In everybody, it is developed. Okay, no problem. They are excreted through the kidney, through that glomerular filtration. Do you remember Bowman's capsule, glomeruli, ascending loop, descending loop, loop of Henle, everything you remember, 12th standard. When the kidney structure is damaged, when the patient's kidneys are not working properly, glomeruli funnel is damaged, then urea and creatinine are not excreted. Kidney cannot do its function, and that urea and creatinine waste product not going out. It is remained in your blood. It is remained in the blood, and that is in more amount, normal than more. So when, of course, urea and creatinine is present in the blood, because through the blood they are filtered in the kidney and going out. So there is optimal level. But above that level, when urea is increased, That is called as an increased level of urea and creatinine in the blood. And if it is found that it is beyond normal limits, then what is your logical inference, anumana praman in Ayurveda? What will be your anumana? The patient must have the problem with the kidney. Are you getting my point? His kidneys are not functioning well. How you diagnose? Because of the investigation of urea and creatinine. Is it clear? And kidney is the most important organ. Remember, any disease cannot be cured if he has the problem in the kidney. Okay? Next, another by chance related complaints are there. Next test which is done as a basic test is LFT. LFT. Liver function test. Liver function test. So there are 3-4 tests, especially we do usually for the jaundice patients always. The important tests are called as SGOT. Just write down the names. We will make it little bit short. SGOT. I will discuss at another time. SGPT. Another test is SGOT, then SGPT. Third, alkaline phosphatase. Alkaline phosphatase. Then bilirubin, total bilirubin. So all these tests together, 4, 5, 6 tests together, they are called as a liver function test. So the doctor must check whether his kidney is normal, whether there is an infection, whether he has any diabetes, why the cough is not getting cured, why the patient's symptoms are not becoming less. So in addition to this hematological or laboratorial test, usually consultant, generally this is done by the consultant, because we general practitioners send the patient to the consultant. Look, he is not getting cured, his cough is not getting cured, his diarrhea is not getting cured, his pain in abdomen is not stopping, his chest pain is not stopping, what to do? Then he do some laboratorial test, plus in addition to that, some radiological test he perform. X-ray chest should be done, PA view, posterior anterior, especially the patient is complaining of cough, X-ray chest is mandatory. You must do the X-ray chest when the patient has cough more than 15 days duration. X-ray chest is mandatory. If the patient is complaining of pain in abdomen, maja pota dukta hai, more than 15 days, the patient must be advised USG abdomen, ultrasonography, USG of abdomen. So all these tests are performed for 2 or 3 reasons. Number one, to rule out any serious disease. By chance he has some hidden disease and we are not finding with the clinical examination, that can be ruled out. Oh, no problem. Kai sage normal ale bar ka kai ghabru naka. Many times the patients grumble. Patient cha takrari astat. Kai patients vaitakta chidtat. हो डॉक्टर काय काय सगळं तुम्ही मला 2000 रुपयाचा खड्ड्याला घातला आणि सगळं नॉर्मल आलंय. म्हणून बिफोर डुईंग दिस टेस्ट, टू अवॉइड द पेशंट्स अँगर और टू अवॉइड द पेशंट मिसअंडरस्टँडिंग, मेक हिम क्लिअर. व्हॉट यू शुड मेक हिम क्लिअर? सी, युअर कंप्लेंट्स आर नॉट कमिंग डाऊन विथ माय और विथ अदर डॉक्टर्स ट्रीटमेंट्स. वी आर ट्राइंग अवर लेवल बेस्ट टू गिव यू अँटीबायोटिक, दिस ड्रग अँड दॅट ड्रग, बट युअर कंप्लेंट्स आर नॉट कमिंग. 15 days have already passed. So if some serious disease is there, you can land into the trouble. That's why as a preventive measure, I am doing this test. I feel nothing will come up. Don't worry. But you better do it. Because if something serious, we can find it out. If nothing, we are happy. We can continue our management, we can continue our treatment. So to make him clear beforehand, before sending him to the lab, before sending him to X-ray, get him clear. No, that nothing to be worried, but I want to check no serious disease is there. Number one. Number two, especially when you are trying for Ayurvedic treatment, no blame should be made on the Ayurvedic people. Especially so-called orthodox Ayurvedic people They say, no, modern, not necessary, only Nadi Pariksha is quite sufficient. This is something, wrong thing, wrong concept in the mind of the people. If you need, you take the help of these modern gadgets and you can continue with Ayurvedic treatment. I will tell you many examples that the doctors go on treating the patients of cough, and after 1 month, cough is not coming, he visits to the modern hospital, there they do the x-ray and he is found to be tuberculosis last 1 month. And they seriously curse to the Ayurvedic physicians. How is doctor useless, foolish? He don't understand, he is playing with the life of the patient. So unnecessary blames are given to the Ayurveda science. Ayurveda science is not bad. This particular doctor is bad. Do you understand? Because he is unnecessary having the superiority complex. Oh, I am the great. Only Nadi Pariksha. Oh, no. Don't take any chance. You can give Ayurvedic, no problem. Before, after, anytime you continue Ayurvedic. But you can take the help of these gadgets to rule out tuberculosis. For example, if the patient has a pain in abdomen, simple thing. You are giving Hingvashtaka Churna, Agni Tundi Vati, Triphala Vati, Trikattu Vati, Panchakola Sava, everything. Massage, sesame oil, basti. But his pain in abdomen is not coming back. If by chance, if there is a tumor, small tumor, small cancer growth in the liver, you have not found out with your Nadi Pariksha, then after 2-3 months when he visits to the modern hospital, again they find out that the patient is suffering from cancer of intestine, cancer of the liver, cancer of stomach, cancer of appendix or appendicitis. So all these things should not happen from the Ayurvedic people. This is my good wish. That's why I have explained all these things, that you should convince to the patient that whatever I am doing, I am Ayurvedic, I will give the Ayurvedic, nothing to be worried about. Pure Ayurvedic medicines I will give. Panchakarma I will do. But I need this investigation to rule out some serious problems. And nowadays, you know, sometimes even in the law of the court, you will be sued. You will be punished for not doing or not taking care of the patient. Because the diagnosis was very serious. And you have, because only Ayurvedic, clinical, sarata, and you have not done this basic test. This is very wrong. I think starting from the Sarata Shlok, we have just diverted our whole lecture on the basis of how the importance of investigations in the even allopathy, Ayurveda, homeopathy practice. But now in last 5 minutes, we will chant the shlokas which are basically based on the subjective parameters or clinical diagnosis of Dhatu Sarata. So first shlok is Rasa Sarata. You chant after me. Tatra Snigdha Shlakshna Mrudu Prasanna. As we are recording, please say loudly. Sukshma Alpa Gambira. Sukumara Loma. Sapravevacha. Tvaksaranam. Sasarata. Sukhasaubhagya Aishwarya. Upaboga Buddhi Vidya. Arogya Pradarshanani. Ayushatvam Chachashte. Remember, Rasasarata is equal to Tvaksarata. For Rasasarata, you must examine the color, complexion and texture of the skin. Don't forget it. It's related with the hydration of the body. How your body is having enough water. If water is good, your skin will be very nice. When the patient is suffering from loose motions, diarrhea, vomiting, he gets dehydration, and as you know, there is a loss of elasticity. So Rasa Sarata is expressed by the skin. Don't Sarata, chant the shloka after me. Karna Akshi Mukha Jivva. Nasa Oshta Pani Padatala. Nakhalalata Mehanam Cha. Snigdharaktam. Srimat. Bhrajishnu. Rakta Saranam. Sa Sarata. Sukham. Uddatam Medham. Manasvitvam, Saukumaryam, Anatibalam, Aklesha Saishnutvam, Ushna Asaishnutvam Cha Achashte. in the Raktasarata, you have to concentrate on the word snigdha rakta. That means luster, luster with red color. And red color specifically you see in the eyes, conjunctiva, nails. These are the important places where you have to check your red color of the blood. Then next comes the Mausa Sarata, where you have to check the muscle mass, or in the latest language it is called as the PAX, 6 abdominal PAX, or you have to test the muscle nutrition. Okay. So you chant the shloka of Mausa Sarata after me. Shankhalalata Krikatika Akshiganda Hanugriva Skanda Udara Kakshavakshaha Pani Pada Sandayaha Guru Sthira Mausa Upachitaha Mausa Saranam Sa Sarata Kshama Dhrutim Alaulyam Vittam Vidyam Sukham Arzavam Arogyam Balam Ayucha Dirigam Achashti. In this shloka, three words are important. Number one, Guru. Number two, Sthirata. And number three, Upachita. How your mouth should be? It should be Guru. Your body weight should be normal. Sthirata, there should not be any cramp or atrophy or the hypertrophy. Consistent muscle mass should be there. Sthirata. And Upachita, nutrition should be proper. Your bulk of the bicep, bulk of the tricep, bulk of the quadriceps, bulk of the gluteal muscles, all these muscles should be in a proper size and shape. Just I remember with this shloka, one again, what you can say, the breaking news or a type of the uncertain news. This has happened because of the Dr. Naik sir's personal request to me in the morning at 9:15 that tomorrow he may be having some afternoon casual leave or half day leave, and so he wanted my lecture of today's to take combined lecture. So as he is also agreeing with me many times, I also have to agree for his request. So unfortunately, I am very sorry, because it is not intimated to, because on the WhatsApp message I have written that today I will take the batch B and tomorrow batch A, and these practicals will happen. But unfortunately, because of Dr. Naik sir's request, today from 2 to 4, RRD will not take any practical. Whole 60 students will be taken care by Dr. Naik sir in the anatomy, in the lecture, whatsoever, dissection or whatsoever he wants. And tomorrow, Tuesday, Dr. Naik will not be there. Tomorrow whole class, 60 students, they will sit in the classroom. Remember my all the instructions properly. If you don't remember, again hear my lecture on the YouTube. So, what we are going to plan, the same planning will be there. You are expected to bring the tailor's tape, so that you are examining your partner's girth of the bicep and tricep especially, and even the thighs and the calf muscle. Then you are doing the test of stereognosis. Then you are provided with the tuning fork, maybe of 100 hertz if possible, and you have to tap on the, or you have to keep the vibration and the patella, that is the vibration sense of the neurological examination. Stereognosis test you have to perform. Stethoscope you will be provided, and you have to write down in your notebook which are the four places where we should examine the mitral valve, tricuspid valve, aortic valve and the pulmonary valve. That four places you should bring in your notebook, that particular write-up. Okay. Now, the sitting arrangement is very special for tomorrow. Remember my words. After lunch break, whatsoever, you have to arrange yourself, rearrangement. How you are going to arrange? This is supposed to be the C1 column, or rather forget about C1 column, but pairwise. When you stand in the laboratory, the same pairs, you should sit in the same pattern over here, so that there will not be any confusion. Wherever you want to sit, you sit, but with the pair only of the laboratory pair. Is it clear? And then you have to bring your journal, bring the pencils and the rubbers, so that whatever the nutrition mass you will take, you will write down in your part, your own journal, while putting the name of your partner. I will be there all the time, moving here and there. Next thing you have to remember that what else you are going to write? Pulse examination, for example. Rate and rhythm, we have dropped that. So you have to count the pulse in the single minute. and check the rhythm. Usually it's a regular. Thak, thak, lap, dap, lap, dap, thak, 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 like that. But you have to count the pulse rate. Usually the doctor is expected to stand or sit on the right side of the patient, but here it may not be possible. This is a practical adjustment for the tomorrow's lecture. When the time permits, we will go again in the laboratory, we will go again in the clinical room, and while lying down, we can also examine all these things. Is it clear to you all? So today from 2 to 4, Dr. Naik will take, and tomorrow from 2 to 4, Dr. RRD will take in the classroom, but with the same pairs as the laboratory. Don't forget to bring the journal, handbook, as well as the practical notebook and some notes about the heart. I have circulated again that those PPT. Do you have? So see the particular, you know, how to take the reflex. Particular figure you should photograph, you should see in the PPT, and then come with preparation. Okay. So now it's exactly at 11 o'clock. I will conclude my lecture over here. You are expected to go for tea. 11 to 11:50 is a tea break. Thank you very much for patience hearing. Have a nice day. Thank you.